It is my great pleasure to be here with you. Unfortunately, not live. Really sorry for that. I will share my screen and we will speak in the next few minutes about the new opportunities in the treatment of endometrial cancer patients. These are my disclosure. So basically, our guidelines were recognized that we have no standard second-line treatment in advanced endometrial cancer. And after the failure of carboplatin paclitaxel, which is well-recognized standard first-line treatment, whichever drug you can use in second-line, the possibility of response is far up under 10-15%, and the median PFS is about 3 months. But very recently, we discovered that endometrial cancer is not a single disease, but at least 4 different tumors with different prognosis and different molecular characteristics that can impact on treatment. Polymute tumor, which represent about 88% of endometrial cancer, have a very good prognosis, and this tumor possibly should not receive any kind of adjuvant treatment, even when diagnosed in advanced stage after surgery. On the opposite, P53 mute tumor, which represent roughly 20% of endometrial cancer, have a very bad prognosis. This patient should receive chemotherapy even when diagnosed at stage 1 disease, and possibly in the future, this patient should also receive PARP inhibitor because chemotherapy seems to be not enough. Then we have the MMRD tumor, tumor linked to instability, microsatellite instabilities. This tumor represents around 30% of endometrial cancer. This tumor presents intermediate prognosis and seems to be not so responsive to chemotherapy. And finally, the non-specific molecular profile tumor, which seems very enriched of hormone receptor positive. This tumor gained limited benefit from chemo, but possibly in the future should be treated with hormonal treatment. These 4 groups of tumor actually may be treated with different therapeutic options. In particular, MSI tumor present an high level of tumor infiltrating lymphocyte, high genomic instability, which means new epitopes. So this characteristic in combination with high level expression of PD-1 suggests that this tumor may respond very well to immunotherapy and checkpoint inhibitor. In fact, when we select according to the biomarker MSI endometrial cancer and treat this patient with checkpoint inhibitor, we are able to evocate responses in up to 57% of patients. This is your experience with the pembrolizumab single agent approved in patient with MSI-linked tumor with advanced or recurrent endometrial cancer, which reported at the last update of the results response rate in 57% of population with long, long duration of response. But what about the other tumor? Tumor without MSI, without instability. For this tumor, actually, we have a good opportunity of care. KEYNOTE-775 was a randomized phase 3 trial comparing the experimental combination of lenvatinib plus pembrolizumab versus physician choice chemotherapy between doxorubicin or weekly paclitaxel In a population of advanced metastatic or recurrent endometrial cancer patients who have received one prior platinum-based chemotherapy. Patients were stratified according to MMR status, and the co-primary endpoint was represented by PFS and overall survival. And the trial met the primary endpoint, and the significant increase in progression-free survival was reported in the MMR-proficient population and in the all-comer patient, where a significant 5 months increase in median PFS was reported. But also overall survival was significantly increased in the MMRP and all-comer population, with the median overall survival, which increases up to 7 months in the all-comer population. Very recently, the results according to histology were presented. This was a not pre-planned analysis, but was very informative from my point of view. The benefit in terms of PFS was reported in all the histotype, high-grade endometrioid, serous and clear cell, and also a significant overall survival was reported in all the histotype. But when I look at the clear cell curves, it's very impressive to see what is the benefit of the combo of TKI inhibitor lenvatinib and immunotherapy pembrolizumab in this population. Looking at the forest plot, we receive another very interesting suggestion. It seems that in patients who have received only one prior line of platinum, the benefit is enhanced with respect to patients more pretreated. This is not surprising because we are working of a less exhausted immune system and probably also on a less resistant disease. So the better, the earlier is the key point of this strategy. The consistency of benefit was also demonstrated by a doubling in overall response rate, which increased from 15 to 30% in this population. What is the key point? The toxicity of the combo requires a learning curve, particularly in a population of elderly ovarian endometrial patient. In this study, 66% of patients experienced a dose reduction and 33% of patients experienced discontinuation of treatment related to adverse events. What are the main adverse events reported? Hypertension, hypothyroidism, diarrhea, nausea, and decreased appetite and vomiting. As you can see, in most part of cases, they were grade 1, 2, with only hypertension in a significant number of grade 3 patients, but it is very informative from my point of view. This subgroup analysis, this exploratory analysis that was presented at ESGO, in which the time interval in which the toxicity appeared was reported. And as you can see, in a median of 2 weeks from starting treatment, hypertension and fatigue occur, followed by musculoskeletal disorder and stomatitis and nausea. Thus suggesting that our clinician, we as a physician, have to manage properly and proactive this toxicity in order to avoid discontinuation and interruption of a treatment which has reported to increase overall survival in our patient. But this toxicity has no impact in quality of life of our patient. Our patient live longer, but have no detrimental effect in terms of quality of life. One of the secondary endpoints of the trial was the evaluation of quality of life at 12 weeks. And at 12 weeks, more than 80% of patients filled the questionnaire of quality of life, We used two different instruments, ARTC QLQ C30 and EQ 5-day VAS. And for both the questionnaire, there were no significant impact on quality of life of our patients treated with pembrolizumab with respect to physician choice chemotherapy. And probably the curves are more informative about the absence of impact or quality of life. When we look at the scare, it was reported an improvement in the emotional functioning scale of patients receiving pembrolizumab, possibly because these patients were experiencing tumor shrinkage due to the increased response rate, and also an improvement in sexual enjoyment, which is, from a point of view, correlated to the first point. In terms of deterioration of symptoms, chemotherapy was associated with a higher hair loss, which is also a problem for a patient, while pembrolizumab was associated with a taste change. Probably symptoms care are more informative. So immunotherapy is changing the natural history also of endometrial cancer. What's the next step? We are trying to combine immunotherapy to PARP inhibitor, to chemo and to radiation treatment. And the next year we will receive the results of a lot of very interesting trials. Two of these trials are combining immunotherapy to chemo in the first line advanced setting. Two of trials are combining immunotherapy to chemo to PARP inhibitor in the first line advanced setting. And one very interesting trial, the LEAP-001 trial, whose result will arrive earlier, possibly Q1 next year, is comparing pembrolizumab versus carboplatin paclitaxel in the first line setting. If this trial is positive, we will have for the first time an alternative to carboplatin paclitaxel standard of care. So, in conclusion, it's clear to me and to all of us that endometrial cancer is not more a single disease, but at least four different tumors with a different prognosis and treatment. Molecular-driven treatment is the future, is the new strategy in endometrial cancer in either setting, adjuvant and advanced disease. We have no doubt that MSI-high tumors are the best target for checkpoint inhibitor single agent, while the combo of pembro plus lenvatinib is absolutely the most effective strategy in MSS, endometrial cancer, determining a significant increase in progression-free, overall survival, overall response rate without detrimental effect in quality of life of our patients. And the future is to try to combine immunotherapy with the chemo, with chemo plus PARP, or possibly for the first time to provide an alternative to carboplatin paclitaxel in the first line metastatic setting. Thank you so much for your attention.